another one. I'll teach you how to do another trick. For this, I'm going to take the liberty of removing my jacket. I hope you don't mind. And thank you, Joe. I'm rolling up my sleeves. It's just that a lot of times people think that we magicians might stoop to using some cheap trick, such as hiding things in special pockets in our jackets or up our sleeves. After the open and honest relationship we've enjoyed so far, I'd hate for you to think such a thing of me. I've got a piece of rope. At one time or another, you've probably seen a magician take a piece of rope and cut it and put it back together again. I'm going to do the same thing, but I'm going to show you step by step how it's done. Before we start, I'd like to have someone from the audience thoroughly examine this piece of rope, make sure it is, in fact, what it appears to be, an ordinary, unprepared piece of rope. Would you, sir, go over every inch of that, okay? That's about all the time. Oh, I kid. Look at it closer than that. Make sure there are no trap doors or mirrors, no hidden assistants. It doesn't stretch or anything like that. Seemed like an ordinary piece of rope. Seemed like an ordinary piece of rope to you. Obviously it is, otherwise I wouldn't have let you look at it. It's just a piece of rope like you find in any bedroom. The secret to this trick is... What? The secret to this trick is not in the rope. It's in a special knot that magicians have kept secret for hundreds of years called the Mongolian Pop Knot. I'm going to show you step by step how to tie this ancient and venerable knot. The first step is to measure the rope carefully. You want to make sure that when you cut, you get two pieces of rope exactly the same length. To put these back together again, you tie a Mongolian pop knot. Here's how it is tied. You take one rope, twist it around the other rope like this. Come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist, come around, and pull tight. You have one Mongolian pop knot. Everybody with me? Good. At this point, you simply reach in your pocket, you take some magic pixie dust. You sprinkle the pixie dust on the knot like so. In a few seconds, that pixie dust will cause the knot to dissolve and pop right off the rope, leaving it where you started from. Now, some of you may have had a hard time seeing exactly how to tie that knot, especially those of you in the cheaper seats. So I'll do it again. This time we'll cut the rope into three even pieces. That gives you twice as much chance to see how the knot is tied. Since it takes two Mongolian pop knots in order to put three pieces of rope back together again. So look, we cut once here, and we cut once down here. That gives us three pieces of rope, all of them about the same length. Remember, when you try this at home, make sure you cut all three pieces of rope the same length. If you make a mistake here, the trick won't work. For example, if instead of cutting three ropes the same length, you were to make a mistake and get one of those ropes a little bit short, the trick won't work. If you get one rope about right, say, and the other rope too long, the trick won't work. All three ropes have to be the same length. Now, this could happen to anybody. So if it happens to you, there is a way out. As long as I am teaching you the trick, I'll teach you what we magicians call a contingency plan. If you make a mistake cutting the ropes, you fold them over one at a time like this. Short, medium, and long, and you say the magic words, sim, salabim. You have to say these with a certain amount of conviction. Sim. Come on, this is the hard part. Sim. Salabim. Suddenly the ropes begin to stretch and stretch and stretch like that, leaving you where you started from. Thank you. Now, back to the Mongolian pop knot. We're going to take rope number one, rope number two. I'm going to tie these together. Watch closely. I'll go slow. You take one rope, twist it around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist, come around, and pull. Now, some of you are laughing, but there's people here trying to learn. You twist, come around, and pull tight. You have one Mongolian pop knot. The second knot is tied the same way. You may want to take notes. You take one rope, twist around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist, come around, and pull tight. You have two Mongolian pop knots. Everybody with me? Yeah. So far, good. At this point, you simply reach in your pocket, take some magic pixie dust. That's very good. That was very studious. You sprinkle the pixie dust on the knots like so. Any questions of so far? What? Question?
Where do you get
pixie dust? There's a question. I grind my own. not just for economy, but for purity. But I would send the kids out of the house because pixies can make a heck of a noise in a blender. It can be distressing for the very young. Okay, any other stupid questions? Because it's the only way we're going to learn. In a few seconds, that pixie dust will cause the knots to dissolve and pop right off the rope, leaving you where you started from. With one, long. Thank you very much, guys.